very simple. It's not complicated.
No, I'm saying the reason why we have to mix it with the saliva.
So all the residents from different planets visited Prithu Maharaj and gave him many different gifts. Because he was the best king they've ever met, and they want to acknowledge that. And everyone in the universe benefited because of him. And so they wanted to give him thanks. So, remember I was saying about the seas and oceans. For jewels, Prabhupada says, Shudras and poor men were allowed to fish. But the higher classes like Kshatriyas and Vaishyas would gather pearls, jewels and coral. Although poor men would catch tons of fish, they would not be equal in value to one piece of coral or pearl. It's a fact. The valuable is jewels are more. In this age, so many factories for the manufacture of fertilizers have been opened, but when the personality of Godhead is pleased by the performance of yajnas, the hills automatically produce fertilizing chemicals which help produce edibles in the fields. Everything is dependent on people's acceptance of Vedic principles of sacrifice. If they know this, they don't have to do artificially so many things. Naturally, and it's more organic. What they're doing is so contaminated, it becomes toxic and pollutants so much. So in India also, I was reading the other day, Delhi is all pollution, heavy pollution. Same thing.
Now Delhi has crossed Beijing as number one. Yeah. Just yesterday I was reading that.
Oh, really? Excellent. Indians always want to be number one. Want to be in the Guinness Book of Records.
Iti chadok sarje shashya.
So now we'll see Indra's exploits from now. Translation. King Prithu was dependent on the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is known as Adokshaja. Because King Prithu performed so many sacrifices, he was superhumanly enhanced by the mercy of the Supreme Lord. King Prithu's opulence, however, could not be tolerated by the King of Heaven, Indra, who tried to impede the progress of his opulence. It's common, this material, when you associate or get conditioned in material life, you think like that. This person is my enemy, this person is my friend. It is like that. You cannot escape from it. Unless you are practicing properly, you will see everyone as your enemy. Right? Yes. So here you see, Indra was thinking like that. This King Prithu is doing so many sacrifices. He is my enemy. He's become my enemy. He's going to take my position. Like that. He's laughing. It's like that. And it's already happening in the time in Satya Yuga. What do you think is happening in Kali Yuga? Even worse. It's happening everywhere, every home you find this. Every place you find this. So although Prithu Maharaj is considered a Shakti Vishavata, still he is a Jiva Atma. So therefore he is a devotee of the Lord, and he tries to please the Lord, and he gets blessings of the Supreme Lord. Prabhupada says in Kali Yuga there are so many self-made incarnations, rascals, who declare themselves to be the Supreme Personality of God. And they call themselves Bhagavan. But actually Bhagavan is a title that you can give to someone who represents the Supreme Personality of Godhead, like Indra. And he's doing it for the conditioned souls. He's helping out certain things we can't see. he brings rain and other things. He's protecting the planet Earth also from the asuras sometimes. So all living entities within this material world has the condition for defects. Okay. Why is Radha also disturbed? What is what's the problem? Right, okay. So even though he is addressed as Bhagavan, out of respect for his position, and that he is also doing service for the Supreme Lord on behalf of Krishna, he is addressed Bhagavan. Still he became envious of Ritu Maharaj. So Prabhupada says we should try to understand therefore how a conditioned soul becomes fallen, because he is envious. He becomes envious. He has free will. He gets envious. Like that. Just looking at someone enjoying, you get envious. Why? It happens. Right? You can see with your own life why sometimes you like some people getting something, you don't like another person getting it. Why is that?
Envy?
Yeah, because you're envious. You're not seeing them as living entities, or you're not seeing them as Krishna's servants. You're seeing differences. You like someone, you don't like another person. It has to be envy. Right? Unless the asuras really fighting against Krishna, like Hiranyakashipu or Ravana, right? So how many Ravanas we have in our association? In the world, it's hardly anything. People can be very strong-minded, strong-willed, opinionated, pig-headed, but that doesn't mean they are asuras. So you don't treat them. But if you do that, then you are exhibiting your envious nature. So Prabhupada talks like that. We become fallen. As soon as we put someone down or become offensive to them, we are fallen already. We are supposed to be serving the Supreme Personality of Godhead. We cannot only one person serve Krishna. Krishna is unlimited. So therefore he has unlimited facilities and unlimited nuances in him, and he has so many different characters and so many things he likes. So one person cannot serve him. Therefore he has unlimited servants, actually. Right? Paragana. So many. Lakshmi Sahasra Sampramanam Govinda Manam. So you have to understand, so many, that also not enough. Countless, infinite number of servants. Therefore we cannot think, I'm the only one who is pure, so I'm going back to God. Right? We cannot think like that. No, we all think like that. Om Tat Sat. Let me meditate. I can meditate. What you meditating? You can't do any meditation. You meditate on yourself. Oh, what I'm going to do right there. That's all you meant.
Ahurupasana.
Yeah. Text 11. Dharame nashvamedena.
Dharame nashvamedena.
Yajamane yajuspatim.
Yajamane yajuspatim.
Vanya yagna vasum spardhan.
Vanya yagna vasum spardhan.
Apovaha tirohitaha.
Apovaha tirohitaha.
When Ritu Maharaj was performing the last horse sacrifice, Ashwamedha Yajna, King Indra, invisible to everyone, stole the horse intended for sacrifice. He did this because of his great envy of King Prithu. This is in the Shastra, they're saying it, that he was envious So Indra himself has done 100 yagnas like that. And therefore he doesn't want anyone to do more than him. So he came to stop this. This is the 100th of Maharaj Prithu. So he came to stop. And even though he shouldn't, he cannot help himself. He just can't help himself. So he came to stop. So Prabhupada says he became very envious because he doesn't want someone to do better than him. So the question as devotees is, we have to see, you know, do we feel that way when someone does better than me? You have to. If you pretend, where's the song? Oh, why you keep doing that? Yesterday also you did that. You have to take it out and put it back in? Could you not just use it in there? That's why it's called the binder. Okay, so when we think like that, oh, this person, you know, why he should do, why I can't do, or sometimes we also think, you know, why this person has to do, I prefer the other person. But who are you? You know, maybe Krishna arranged for that person to do it. Let them do it.
There must be one more Indra before him. Right? And he tried to impede.
So sometimes the Indra can be a pure devotee also. So then they don't bother. Sometimes when the Indra is not qualified and there's no other qualified, then Krishna will come. Like that. So in this case, this Indra, he could not accept it. That's what. We have to learn from these things, otherwise we will make the same mistake in our existence here. We see everybody as our competitor. Anyone who disagrees with me, boom, shoot them, kill them. Right? Like that's a political situation, right? That's what they do. They bring the guy down, they say bad things about and then they destroy them and they kick them out. That's the political situation in this country.
So, I mean, they have not allowed any other devotee to make 100 yagyas. Looks like that.
Yeah, that's what it is. He doesn't.
I mean, he said many of them he stopped. Right?
Yeah, he stopped, which we earlier on we were talking about. He interrupts them. He's afraid that they are coming for his position. He's not thinking they're doing it for their own benefit. No. As soon as someone has done 100 means they are qualified to take his position.
In next life, right? Or he'll be displaced immediately? Or why is he? That's why he's so afraid.
That's why he's very worried. Because once you reach that many, you already qualified.
That's only Lord Rama did so many years, right?
I'm sure they did many. He's a Supreme Lord.
Yeah, so he can't stop.
And he knows the Supreme Lord is going to go back after.
No acceptable position.
Text 12. Namatrir Bhagavanakshad.
Namatrir Bhagavanakshad.
Swaramanam Vihayashad. When King Indra was taking away the horse, he dressed himself to appear as a liberated person. Actually, this dress was a form of cheating, for it falsely created an impression of religion. When Indra went into outer space in this way, the great sage Atri saw him and understood the whole situation. So a fallen person is sometimes known as Pakhanda or Pashandi. Here is an imposter.
Pakhanda is a common word actually.
The Prabhupada says it indicates imposter. That means he's pretending to be religious, but he's actually not. He's doing a sinful activity. He's trying to stop Prithu Maharaj from doing a yagna. So that's a sinful act. And he also was wearing a saffron.
Saffron robes.
So Prabhupada says this saffron has been misused by many imposters. So later on you'll see even Ravana does that also. Mm. They're all following in that sampradaya imposter. So in this way, people are cheated, and that's what we are seeing. So many sannyasis who are not even following sannyas ashram. So there's a tendency to cheat, and they go on cheating one person after another person. So this was started by Indra. So he's not liberated from the clutches of material contamination, and he wants to pretend to be liberated. That's what we are seeing. And so we find that even in our present society, so many people are pretending to be liberated personalities. That they have renounced this, but then they do nonsense behind the fact. Srila Prabhupada, in his biography, you see how he saw some of these persons were coming home, they're sitting home in the family, and then in the morning they wear the sannyas face and go out to collect money.
Profession.
Yeah. The actual sannyas means everything is done for Krishna. Nothing for me. No, I'm not doing it for myself. Unattached to the fruits of the work, not doing it for some results. All the results are given to Krishna. That is a real sannyas. So externally one can take sannyasi, but if they are not giving the results to Krishna, then they are not sannyasi. So Prabhupada says cheating sannyasis and yogis have existed since the time of Prithu Maharaj's sacrifice. So Prabhupada says this cheating was very foolishly introduced by King Indra to the material world. In some ages such cheating is very prominent, in other ages not so prominent. So sannyasi must be very careful. As Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, sannyasila alpa chitra sarva loke gaya. A little spot in a sannyasi's character will be magnified by the public. Therefore, unless one is very sincere and serious, he should not take up the order of sannyasa. One should not use this order as a means to cheat the public. It is better not to take up sannyasa in this age of Kali, because provocations are very strong in this age. Very strong. Sense gratifying. Only a very exalted person advanced in spiritual understanding should attempt to take up sannyasa. One should not adopt this order as a means of livelihood or for some material purpose. Otherwise, you do that, you are fallen. Immediately you are fallen. We should never cheat another person. We should know where we are spiritually also. You know, not pretend to say, oh, I'm better. Just because you know 10 shloka, the other guy in 1 shloka, yeah, you are slightly better than the other person, but it doesn't mean you are advanced and so on. It's not like that.
Actually, there was one lady in my bhakti riksha long time ago, 2004, 2005. In her school, they made her memorize Bhagavad Gita, so she knows basically end to end. And everybody used to be like, wow, this is so great. And then she stopped coming, and all the people who didn't know shlokas have become devotees. She became a dentist now.
Okay. That's the thing. Atkrina chodito hantum.
Atkrina chodito hantum.
When the son of King Prithu was informed by Atri of King Indra's trick, he immediately became very angry and followed Indra to kill him, calling, "Wait, wait." The words tista tista used by Kshatriya when he challenges his enemy. When fighting, a Kshatriya cannot flee from the battlefield. However, when a Kshatriya out of cowardice flees from the battlefield, showing his back to his enemy, he is challenged with the words tista tista. A real Kshatriya does not kill his enemy from behind, nor does a real Kshatriya turn his back on the battlefield. So because King Indra stole, he became degraded. And so he's running away, feeling very scared of the whole situation. So therefore, according to the rules, the son of Prithu challenged him using the word tista tista, saying, wait, wait. Why don't you turn around and fight? That's 15. Tanda drikshakritim vichya.
Tanda drikshakritim
vichya. Mene dharmam sharirinam.
Mene dharmam sharirinam.
Jatilam basmanat channam.
Jatilam basmanat channam.
Nasmai banam namuchati.
Tasmai banam namuchati.
King Indra was fraudulently dressed as a sannyasi, having knotted his hair on his head and smeared ashes all over his body. Upon seeing such dress, the son of King Bhrigu considered Indra a religious man and pious and just. Therefore, he did not release his arrows. So you can see, they by culture, they don't, they respect a sannyasi. But Indra is fraudulently dressed as sannyasi, so he's spoiling the ashram there. The Varna, text 15. Vadanimritam tambuyo.
Vadanimritam tambuyo.
Antavetri vachodaya.
Antavetri vachodaya.
Jahiyatna hanam tata.
Jahiyatna hanam tata.
Mahendram vibhudadanam.
Mahendram vibhudadanam.
When Atri Muni saw that the son of King Prithu did not kill Indra but returned deceived by him, Atri Muni again instructed him to kill the heavenly king because he thought that Indra had become the lowliest of all demigods' duties in impeding the execution of King Prithu's sacrifice. So Atri Muni didn't see anything wrong in killing King Indra because he has become fallen. So immediately he said, kill this man. He's going against religious principles. Because he's stealing, so one who steals, you know, like that you can kill. Text 16.
Evam vanya suta proktas.
Evam vanya suta proktas.
Dvaramanam vihayasa.
Anvadravat avikrudho.
Anvadravat avikrudho.
Ravanam gridhararativa.
Ravanam gridhararativa.
When thus informed, the grandson of King Vena immediately began to follow Indra, who was fleeing through the sky in great haste. He was very angry with him, and he chased him just as the king of the vultures chased Ravana. You remember the past time when he was kidnapping, and then Jatayu went to save him, and then he got killed. Text 17. Sosvam rupam chatartitva.
Sosvam rupam chatartitva.
Nasmantar hita swarat.
Nasmantar hita swarat.
Virasva pashunadaya.
Virasva pashunadaya.
Pitu yagnam upeyivan.
Pitu yagnam upeyivan.
When Indra saw that the son of Prithu was chasing him, he immediately abandoned his false dress and left the horse. Indeed, he disappeared from that very spot, and the great hero, the son of Maharaj Prithu, returned the horse to his father's sacrificial arena. So Indra got caught, he didn't know what to do, he left the horse and disappeared. Text 18. Tattasya chadbutam karma.
Tattasya chadbutam karma.
Vichakshya paramarshaya.
Vichakshya paramarshaya.
Dear Lord Vidura, when the great sages observed the wonderful powers of the son of King Prithu, they all agreed to give him the name Vijitashva. Vijitashva means he got it back. He won the horse. Text 19. Upasritya tamastibram.
Upasritya tamastibram.
Jaharashvam punarhari.
Jaharashvam punarhari.
Chashala yupatas channo.
Chashala yupatas channo.
Hiranya rashanam vibhu.
Hiranya rashanam vibhu.
My dear Vidura, Indra, being the king of heaven and very powerful, immediately brought against darkness upon the sacrificial arena. Covering the whole scene in this way, he again took away the horse, which was chained with golden shackles near the wooden instrument where animals were sacrificed.
Okay, I have a question. In the word to word, it says Hari and they refer to as King Indra. Why is that?
Where is this?
In the word to word, it says.
For 19 word to word, Harihi is translated as King Indra.
Yeah. Well, the word Hari could also refer, it has more than one meaning. So he's representing.
Because he's very powerful.
Yeah, he's representing the Supreme Personality of Godhead as the Heavenly King. So sometimes he's called Bhagawan, sometimes he's referred probably as Hari. But he's not Hari.
If you see the word Punar Arihi, Punar means again. Arihi means taken away again.
Okay, you could say that also.
He is taken
away.
The person
who takes
the person who took.
The
so he took the horse, so he is therefore Hari.
Referring to Hari.
Hari means one who takes everything, so that's the other word. Hari could also, it refers to Krishna also, it refers to one who takes everything. Thanks. Thanks, 20, na?
Atri
sandarshayam asha
Atri sandarshayam asha
Ramanam yahayasha
Ramanam yahayasha
Kapala katvam gadaram
Kapala katvam gadaram
Great sage Atri again pointed out to the son of King Prithu that Indra was fleeing through the sky. The great hero, the son of Prithu, chased him again. But when he saw that Indra was carrying in his hand a staff with a skull at the top and was again wearing the dress of the sannyasi, he still chose not to kill him. So again he dressed as another kind of mendicant. Another outfit, this time with a staff.
Scumless.
Text 21. Atrina choditas tasmai.
Atrina choditas tasmai.
Sandade vishikam rusha.
Sandade vishikam rusha.
Soshum rupam chatadhitva.
Soshum rupam chatadhitva.
Astavantar hitaswara.
Astavantar hitaswara.
Great sage Atri again gave directions. The son of King Prithu became very angry and placed an arrow on his bow. Upon seeing this, King Indra immediately abandoned the false dress of a sannyasi and, giving up the horse, made himself invisible. The second time, text 22. Veerashchasvam upadaya
Veerashchasvam upadaya
Pitriyatnam matavraja
Pitriyatnam matavraja
Tat avadhyam hare rupam
Tat avadhyam hare rupam
Jagrihur jnana durbala
Jagrihur jnana durbala
Then the great hero Vijitashva, the son of King Prithu, again took the horse and returned to his father's sacrificial arena. Since that time, certain men with a poor fund of knowledge have adopted the dress of a false sannyasi. It was King Indra who introduced this. So then Prabhupada is referring to people who are impersonalists and so on. So he talks about sannyasis in the purport, types of sannyasis. From the beginning, they used to carry three danda. Then Shankaracharya introduced the ekadandi. That means they are only one, everybody is one. Three danda means there is the Supreme Lord, the Jiva, and his service. And then mind, words, and action for the Supreme Lord. And so then the Jiva, so it's three dandi. And the Supreme Lord. There are many types of sannyasis who are not approved by Vedic rituals. A type of pseudo sannyasa was introduced by Indra. So Indra created a new category of sannyasis when he tried to hide himself from the attack of Vijitashva, the great son of King Prithu. Now there are many different types of sannyasis. Some of them go naked. You find that in the
Kumbh Mela,
all the Nagabhavas. Mm-hmm. And some of them carry a skull you see that also, and trident, generally known as Kapalika. All of them are introduced under some meaningless circumstances. And those who have poor fund of knowledge accept these false sannyasis and their pretenses, although they are not bona fide guides to spiritual life. So you can see that, very common. People mistake what is spiritual life for this kind of activities. We should be very careful. Okay. So in the scripture, Prabhupada says, sinful activities are no illicit sex, no intoxication, no meat eating, and no gambling. But all these so-called sannyasis, they do these things mainly. Prabhupada is pointing us, this is not correct. And they give all kinds of reasons. And they drink ganja and smoke all those heroin. And when you tell them why you're doing it, they say, well, Lord Shiva is doing it, I can do it. So, but Lord Shiva drank poison, so why don't you drink poison? Right? That they won't say. Nonsense. And how do you know Lord Shiva is taking ganja? They were sitting next to Lord Shiva and he was taking. What nonsense. Some people say like that, but I don't know. I don't think so. These sannyasis, they eat meat, flesh, fish, eggs, and just about everything. Basically, they have no rules or regulations. They sometimes drink with the excuse that without alcohol, fish, and meat, it is impossible to remain in cold countries near the Arctic zone.
Why do you want to stay there?
Hey, I've heard when I was growing up, some of them, not sannyasi, but ordinary people will say, cold country, you must eat fish, must eat a lot of meat. And then to digest that, you need alcohol. They will talk like that. And I was wondering where they come up with these things. The sannyasis introduce all the sinful activities in the name of serving the poor, and consequently poor animals are cut to pieces and go into the bellies of these sannyasis. So Prabhupada is very sarcastic. So they are known as Pakandis, Pashandis. Yeah, so they even say Narayana is Daridara Narayana, or Bhagavan Narayana, like that. Such nonsense. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, this is mentioned, in Kali Yuga, the Pakandis are very prominent. However, Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is trying to kill all these Pakandis by introducing his Sankirtan movement. Those who take advantage of the Sankirtan movement of the International Society for Krishna Consciousness will be able to save themselves from the influence of these Pakandis. So we should not dilute our teachings of Srila Prabhupada by mixing the teachings with some other nonsense. Sometimes devotees unnecessarily they'll go and read the Puranas and without asking someone, why you're doing this actually? Srila Prabhupada never asked us, why are you doing it? Well, it is in the Purana. But Prabhupada never asked us. Right? Some devotees started to do it. I mean, I'm not against it, but I question why. I wanted to know why also. Like Bhishma Panchatara. Right? Prabhupada never introduced that. Right? So then these devotees are doing it. The last five, after Kartik or something.
Yes, the last five days of the Kartik.
Yeah, so then why are they doing it? Who asked them to do? Some avatar came and told them. I mean, our Acharya has given us something, so why we are doing all this extra? I'm curious, I'm not saying they can't do it, but are they eating from the floor? First day you can do one item, second day another. All the time your hands must be behind. You cannot shave, you cannot cut fingernails, you cannot do anything. You have to grow hair, and then you have to bend down on the ground and eat. There's no spices, nothing.
And you have to eat only whatever you can in one bend. You cannot go back and forth.
There you go. But these are done by ritualists, to go back to get some higher position. But are you doing it for the pleasure of Krishna? Or are you just doing so you can tell, I got one up my scorecard and I've done this.
Some devotees won't want to fast from greed, so sometimes that's also okay.
But you have to do it to say, Krishna, I'm doing it, so you please give me some intelligence, my austerity, so then I can become a better devotee. Not that I'm doing it to lose weight. You know, right? People do that. I don't want to lose 5 pounds, 10 pounds. No, then your whole point is meaningless, isn't it? Oh, you're sure you get benefit for sure, but are you connecting with Krishna? That's my point. I want to know.
But the Bhagavad Gita is that the transcendentalist should not give up these activities like charity and austerity.
Yeah, our charity is what? It's giving people
Krishna.
And our austerity.
Our austerity is for any little
principles. And following Ekadashi.
Ekadashi, Vrat, Janmashtami,
appearance
day. It's already there. Some people say they don't do book distribution, so they want to do some more austerity. Okay, chant more rounds. Read more books. Right? That's real austerity, right? Reading Prabhupada's books. Krayana. Spend 2 hours a day on the Kartik just reading. Anyway.
So Prabhupada, this
no, not that I've ever heard.
Chaturmas,
yes. It's in the scriptures.
But Prabhupada asked
us to. Yes. He talks about it. He says we should do that.
Okay.
That's why we are doing. But Purushottam, he never mentioned it. He was in the planet for 12 years, you know. But he never mentioned it.
So I got two different answers on Chaturmas. Some people said do it. Some people said it's for the geographic area of India, so you don't have to do it in America.
No, Prabhupada says, told his disciples to do it.
Do it.
Yeah. So we do it, but yeah, it's basically the whole point was in India there was abundance of pastime, right? Yeah, but it's austerity for us. We're doing it and then we worship Krishna. Krishna, this month I'm not taking a book. But let me think more of you. Whenever I think of milk, how you cherish milk, how you played with the cows and like that.
I think Pandava and Nirjala Ekadasi is also not there.
That is not the fact that Pandava and Nirjala Ekadasi is for all Ekadasi. It's no such thing.
Mm-hmm.
We
still
do
Nirjala.
We do that.
Yeah, yeah. You just do it, but
you
it's nothing
do
like that.
Anytime.
It's just created.
It's not created.
Yeah,
it's on
Pandava
and
Pandava.
No, see, the thing is, Bhishma.
It was for.
No, Bhima.
Only for Bhima.
The thing is, Bhima was unable to do it, and he requested. So he was given this one day for him. I've never read in that scripture that for all eternity anyone can do for all. So people say, you know, when I first joined, that's what they told me.
Yeah.
You do that for the whole, if you miss anyone. There's no such thing.
Mm-hmm.
So how do you compensate for any misses?
You do the next day. You just do the next day and then move on, you know. Prabhupada just told his disciples, just do next day if you forget, that's it. So we follow our acharya.
So
Purushottam
is that adhikman.
Yeah.
It's not.
Srila Prabhupada in the Naipasa.
Okay.
So I also asked some senior Vaishnavas, they also don't know what to say.
Mm.
Yeah. It is in the Puranas, it's nothing wrong if you do it.
But Prabhupada never
mentioned, so I don't know what to say. I let the GBC come up with their own conclusion on this. You know, we are nobody.
Prabhuji, I have a question here. So we have like 10 offenses. In the 10 offenses, we have the second offense, right? To consider the names of the demigods like Lord Shiva or Lord Brahma to be equal to or independent of the Holy One. So we see that these 10 offenses are coming from like Padma Purana. So with the same, this verse, the verse here, Yastu Narayana Devam Brahma Rudra Adita Ivatam Samatvena Iva Vikshate Sapashandi Daved Dhruvam.
Mm-hmm.
So they didn't mention which Purana this is from, right? They said it's only Purana. From Purana. Do you know which Purana this verse is?
Oh, you want to know? This,
yeah,
it's
this
probably
particular
from what? Padma Purana?
Is this taken from Padma?
I don't know. Someone can do the research.
So I know the 10 offenses were taken from Padma Purana.
If it's then, but this one is not right. No, this is possibly from Padma Purana.
What is the meaning of this
one? That you cannot consider the demigods like Brahma,
Shiva,
Nikola on the same level as Narayana, otherwise they are considered an offender or
Pashandi.
It is from Chaitanya Charitamrita actually.
No, that's not the.
No, this is not
from
Purana.
It says Vaishnava Tantra, right?
Okay, that's not.
No, it says Purana. It's stated in the Puranas.
No, here. In the Vaishnava Tantra, it is said.
Oh, this book is different? Okay, here it is.
Here it's mentioned.
Yeah, it is Chaitanya Madhya 18.116.
I know, but it's not.
It's, not
it's quoted from.
It's quoted.
There.
It's
quoted.
It's quoted.
It's quoted in Vaishnava Tantra. It's
okay, so his book is updated.
Vaishnava
it says Vaishnava Tantra.
Vaishnava Tantra.
Is
it both?
I don't know.
Okay, so then the latest one should have that. Vaishnava Tantra. Okay, text 23. Jnani Rupani Jagrihe
Jnani Rupani Jagrihe
Indrohaya Jihishaya
Indrohaya Jihishaya
Jnani Papasya Kandani
Papasya Kandani
Lingam Gandam Yochate Whatever different forms Indra assumed as a mendicant because of his desire to seize the horse, the symbols of atheistic philosophy. So because of him, after that, so many different followers, they started to adopt the false sannyas dress. So Prabhupada says, Bhagavatam says these are symbols of atheistic philosophy. Carrying a danda with a skull on it and stuff like that. So he introduced this because he was envious of Maharaj people. So Prabhupada says no one can introduce a new system into the Vedic way of life. If one does so out of malice is to be known as Pashandi or atheist. In the Vaishnava Tantra it says, then his same verse is quoted.
Same.
So in the previous the editors they missed it out.
Okay.
So there they call Daridra Narayana, Swami Narayana. Yeah. Because he is not really Narayana, they call him Swami Narayana. Text 24-25. Evamindre harati ashvam
Evamindre harati ashvam
Vanya yagna jigamsaya
Vanya yagna jigamsaya
Tadgrihita vishvishteshu
Tadgrihita vishvishteshu
Akhandeshu matirnirnam
Akhandeshu matirnirnam
Dharma iti upadharmeshu
Dharma iti upadharmeshu
Nakna rakta padadishu This way King Indra, in order to steal the horse from King Prithu's sacrifice, adopted several orders of sannyasa. Some sannyasis go naked and sometimes they wear red garments and pass under the name of Kapalika. These are simply symbolic representations of their sinful activities. These so-called sannyasis are very much appreciated by sinful men because they are all godless atheists and very expert in putting forward arguments and reasons to support their case. Like Mayavadis. We must know, however, that they are only passing as adherents of religion and are not so in fact. That means they don't practice any religion. Unfortunately, bewildered persons accept them as religious and when attracted to them, they spoil their lives. Right? They come in, they change their life, they take their money, do so many nonsense. They have to take their wives, so many things. There's only one religion and that is Krishna consciousness. Everything else is not bona fide. Okay? people who pretend otherwise are nonsense, and you should be careful how you deal with them. Just smile at them, get out. Concocted religion. Text 26. Tadabhignaya Bhagavan.
Tadabhignaya Bhagavan.
Pritu Pritu Parakramaha.
Pritu Pritu Parakramaha.
Indraya Kubito Banam.
Indraya Kubito Banam.
Adatto Dhyata Karmukaha. Maharaj Prithu, who was celebrated as very powerful, immediately took up his bow and arrows and prepared to kill Indra himself, because Indra had introduced such irregular sannyas orders. That is the way the leaders should be. As soon as he sees something wrong, they should chop it off. Right? But they are not, because why? They are not religious anymore. They compromise. So you get all kinds of nonsense. Prabhupada says, unfortunately, they are cowards who declare a secular state. The leaders are cowards. They don't want to face what is right. They want to compromise. So they compromise religious and irreligious systems. And that's what you see. People don't know what they are. They don't know what is right or wrong. Right?
Mm.
And therefore, some people want guns. Some people don't want guns. So they don't know what is right or wrong. And just deteriorates and continues. All society go to hell. Text 27.
When Prabhupada says Krishna consciousness, does he mean ISKCON or, like, for example, Prabhupada, God brothers also could be unified, right?
Yeah, as long as they are following the system. But in general, for in world situation, only ISKCON is preaching. Even the Gauriyamas can't preach. They can't.
There is one person.
They try, but they don't.
Yeah, I saw one Gaudiya Sannyasi, he just had a couple of disciples, they were just going in the airport like that and asleep.
They can, but they cannot. The worldwide movement like ours, they are not on that level. Prabhupada was empowered. So we are doing on behalf of Prabhupada. We don't have the power, we are all zero. So we just do what Prabhupada wants. Anyway, I guess we can stop here. What happened?
He's asking what is Gaudiya. Yes,
Prabhupada is